Students, we will discuss today about the volumetric expansion or volume expansion of solid when it is heated. Volumetric expansion of solid. The definition is now what exactly we will be doing here is we will take a solid which has volume, suppose like a metal slab, and you heat it, its length, breadth and height, all three dimension will change, its length, breadth and height. So it will expand in 3D way, 3D manner, all dimensions will change, therefore the slab as a whole will change in terms of its volume. The volume will change to. So, we will exactly proceed the way we have done so far in case of a linear expansion or superficial expansion of solid. We will consider a solid slab or a metal slab which has a certain volume V0 at a particular temperature 0 degree centigrade, then we will proceed and find other things. Now, volumetric expansion solid definition is that the expansion of a expansion of the volume of the solid. Okay. Okay, so heat creates expansion of volume. This is the definition of volumetric expansion. Now, the explanation part. In this part, we will be taking a just like before, we will take a slab. This is metal slab and this is its volume is V0 corresponding to temperature 0 degree centigrade. Now if you heat it, it will change, its volume will change. I can draw another diagram here or I will just expand it here. So the volume will change, how it will look like this. Something like this. This is changing to this length. This is like this. Something like this will happen. And therefore, it will expand. This is the volume VT corresponding to temperature T degree centigrade. This is the volume V0 corresponding to temperature 0 degree centigrade. Now, we will again find the final expression for the volume of the solid when its temperature increases from 0 degree centigrade to T degree centigrade. So, what actually we are doing is when the temperature increases from 0 degree centigrade to T degree centigrade, its volume was originally V0 and it becomes VT. So, we want to find VT. Okay. So, again, we have to proceed from the experimental observations that the observation might have been with different quantities and different parameters, but they might have could not get anything in other things. But the result what we are studying here is the result of the variation of the increase in volume with the original volume and the change in temperature. They might have performed with other parameters, other factors also, but that did not, that means the change in volume will doesn't depend on other parameters. So they neglected that. So we are only dealing with these two terms. That is, it is found that from experiment, that the increase in volume directly proportional to original volume at the OD centigrade. Second is rise in temperature. So the increase in volume depends on the rise in temperature. So if I consider these two factors again, the increase in volume is Vt minus V0, original volume is V0 at 0 degree centigrade, rise in temperature is delta T. If we write them together, that means Vt minus V0 is V0 delta T. So from equations, so we will make equations and then define what constant we are going to introduce in this case. Now from this we get Vt here to introduce some constant. This alpha is proportional to sine, so you to introduce constant. The constant is gamma. Here this constant is called gamma. So alpha, beta, gamma. Alpha is for coefficient of linear expansion. Beta is coefficient of superficial expansion or areal expansion, and gamma stands for the coefficient of volumetric or cubical expansion. So gamma V naught delta T. So from this we'll write the expression for Vt. Thus Vt becomes, this will go to the other side of the equation, and becomes V naught plus gamma V naught delta T. Now this is the final expression, that Vt is V naught 1 plus gamma delta T, where this gamma coefficient of volumetric expansion. We will define this gamma. Okay, we will define gamma and write its unit. Okay, now definition. Gamma, that is coefficient of volumetric expansion. So from the previous relation, we'll write the relation that the gamma is found to be so from this expression we'll define this, that is the increase in volume per original volume at 0 degree centigrade per degree rise in temperature. So friends, we are discussing about the volumetric expansion. So just define this here, that it is defined as the increase in volume for original volume at 0 degree centigrade per degree rise in temperature. Now, what will be its unit? Its unit will be here unit of comma is unit of volume unit of temperature. So this will cancel and that is left with temperature. So Kelvin minus 1 or degree centigrade minus 1. The unit of alpha, beta, gamma are same. The basic they define their basic coefficients in their respective dimensions. The alpha represents the coefficient of linear expansion, beta represents the coefficient of areal expansion, gamma represents the coefficient of volumetric expansions. So they have their same units are defined in similar way, change in dimension of an original dimension per degree rise in temperature. Now in our next video we will be deriving relations. Now in these cases we have assumed the length to be at 0 degree centigrade, the plate in case of areal expansion we have taken the plate at 0 degree centigrade, that is A0, where the volume of the slab was V0 at 0 degree centigrade. That means the formula that we have derived, LT equals to L0 into 1 plus alpha delta T, is valid when what is given is the length at 0 degree centigrade. So that means to start with 0, then you raise the temperature to a certain value. But if in the question, in the numerical, if you are asked to find the final length of the rod say at 200 degree centigrade, if the initial length, the length corresponding to 50 degree centigrade is given to you, then can we use that equation? Because that equation LT, L0, L0 is the length corresponding to 0 degree centigrade, which is not given to us. Only the length that is given is at 50 degree centigrade, then you move to some other 150 degree centigrade. In that case, which type of equation are we going to use? This we will discuss in our next video, that for any temperature, we will consider any temperature, say T1 to any other temperature T2, then we will derive relations of the length of the final length of that equations. And also area and volume. Okay, thank you.